everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are going to do the candle in a jar experiment. For this one, you're going to need a pan or a plate or just something that can hold water. Really just need something that has a little bit of a lip to it. You're going to need candles. I have some tea candles here. You can really use any type of candle, but I think the experiment looks cooler if you can use a candle that floats on water. Of course, you're going to need a lighter to light the candles. Make sure you have some adult supervision for that one. And you need a mason jar or a glass. I'm using a vase that can fit over the top of those candles. And a little bit of water for your pan here. I'm just going to add my last bit of water here. And to be able to see the effect a bit more, I'm going to add some food coloring to this. So just a few drops of food coloring in there. And let's mix that up right here. I'm using purple. That looks beautiful. Okay, so first I want to show you what the effect looks like when we just add our candles. So I'm going to add, let's see, I think just 5 tea candles here. And then put them under, oh boy, put them under your jar, just like so. So nothing really happens, right? We don't really see much of anything. Okay, so let's do that again. And I'm gonna replace these with some dry candles. Okay. So let's watch what happens when I put the vase on top of the candles. You can hear some air releasing through those bubbles. The flames are slowly going out. And there it goes. And the water level is rising. Okay, so there are 2 things going on here. One is a chemical reaction and one is a physical one. The chemical reaction is we saw that the flames were igniting, right? So there's a chemical reaction happening between the paraffin wax and the oxygen inside of our vase. That's creating, that's gonna be through the act of combustion, and we're gonna get carbon dioxide and water, right, through that combustion process. That's a chemical reaction. But the important part to note is that through that chemical reaction, it's burning more oxygen than it is creating water and CO2 and carbon dioxide. So the end result is we have less air inside of our jar. Number 2 is a physical reaction. We saw when those candles were lit, that was heating up the air. And what happens when air is heated up? Well, those molecules are dancing a lot faster. They're moving around and moving away from each other. They're expanding. They're taking up more space. We heard some bubbles. That was a lot of the air escaping out of the jar. And then once those candles go out, once those candles can't get enough oxygen, they go out. And then the air starts to cool down. That creates a low pressure environment. So between our chemical reaction, we have less air inside of our vase. We have cooler air that's condensing. We have this low pressure environment that's creating suction and sucking in the water in our pan, which is causing that to rise up in our vase. And that is the candle in a jar experiment.